Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as debt to equity ratio formula. Now, this is really an important ratio because this determines the company's level of debt that they are exposed to compared to their equity. The higher the debt is not a good sign for the company's financial health. So let's see what goes in and around, and then the nitty-gritty of the debt to equity ratio formula. It means the total liabilities divided by the shareholders' equity. Okay, this is just a formula, but we need to get into all the details. So let's start. Debt to equity ratio formula is viewed as the long-term solvency ratio. It is known as the long-term solvency ratio, and it is a comparison between the external finance and the internal finance. Now, let's have a look at the debt to equity formula and learn about how things will go about. The debt to equity formula, or the ratio, is equal to the total liabilities divided by the shareholders' equity. So this is the formula. In the numerator, we'll take the total liabilities of the firm, and in the denominator, we'll consider the shareholders' equity. So as the shareholders' equity includes the preferred stock, we also consider that. Now, let's understand with the help of an example so that we have a clear idea. There's a company called, let's say, a youth company, and it has some following details, which are as follow: the current liabilities, the non-current liabilities, the common stock, and the preferred stocks. So the current liability, let's say, is standing at $49,000, non-current liability as $110,000, $111,000. Let's say the common stocks are having 20,000 shares of, let's say, 25 each, and the preferred stock value is $140,000. Find out the debt to equity ratio of the youth company over here. So in this example, we have all the information, and all we need to do is to find out the total liabilities of the company. Total liability and the total shareholders' equity of the company. Let's calculate that. Now, the total liability is equal to your current liability plus the non-current liability. So that's going to be your 49,000 plus 1,01,000. That gives us 1,60,000 as our total liability. The next we have is the total shareholders' equity, which is equal to your common stock. Is equal to common stock plus any preferred stock. So in our case, it's going to be 20,000 shares plus 20,000 shares. We have to multiply the price, 20,000 into 25 plus 1,40,000. So that gives us 6,40,000 as our total shareholders' equity. So let's finally put down the numbers in the formula. So our debt to equity formula will be the total liabilities divided by the total shareholders' equity. Well, the total liabilities goes about 1,60,000 divided by the total shareholders' equity is 6,40,000, so 0.25. So in normal situation, This is good. I mean, in normal situation, a ratio of 2 is to 1 is considered quite healthy. You can see that. And from generic perspective, youth company use a little more external financing, and it will also help them in accessing the benefits of the financial leverage. Let's understand the explanation part of the debt to equity ratio formula. See, by using the debt to equity ratio formula, the investor gets to know how a firm is doing in its capital structure, right? And also how solvent the firm is as whole. So when an investor decides to invest in a company, he or she needs to know the approach of a company. So if the total liability of the company, if that is higher or greater compared to the shareholder's equity, I'll just write SE over here, then the investor would think whether to invest in the company or not, because having too much debt is too risky for a firm to be in the long run. So if the liability of the company, if it is too low compared to the shareholder's equity, then the investor would also think twice about investing in the company, because then the company's capital structure is not conducive enough to achieve the financial leverage. So however, if the company balances both the internal and the external finance, then maybe the investor would feel that the company is idle for the investment. Now in this particular graph, what you can see is the ratio, debt to equity ratio of PepsiCo, or Pepsi basically. The debt to equity ratio, right from 2009 onwards, as you can see, there was a rise, then there was a fall, then it took a rise, it was stable, there was a slight rise in that, then it took a huge roundup in 2014 around. So you can see that it was around 0.5x, close enough to that, around 2009-2010. However, it started rising rapidly and is at 2.792 currently, and looks like an over-leveraged situation at this very moment, you can see. This example was just taken to make you understand that how you analyze this particular ratio for any company. Now, what is exactly the use of the debt-to-equity ratio formula? See, the formula for debt-to-equity ratio is very common ratio in terms of the solvency. Now, if an investor wants to know the solvency of the company, debt to equity ratio will be the first ratio to cross the mind. See, by using the debt to equity ratio, the investor not only understands the immediate stance of the company, but also can understand the long-term future of the company. Now, for example, let's take an example. If a company is using too less of the external finance, so let's say the external finance is less, usage is too less, you can say that, and through debt to equity, the investor basically, they would be able to understand that the company is trying to become whole equity firm over here, because they are not going for more external finance, and as a result, the firm wouldn't be able to use the financial leverage in the long run. See, taking debt is not a bad thing, but over leveraging is going to be a turmoil situation for the company. So there should be a mix, a balance. So that's why we say that 2:1 ratio is considered as good, right? Now, this is the calculator that you can use. Let's say your total debt is standing at 1 million and your total shareholder equity is, let's say, 5 lakh. So it's 2. If you increase this to 2, it will increase to 4. And if you reduce this to 5, it will reduce to, let's make it 5 lakh. Then it will reduce to 1x. So you make your own assumptions over here, put down some numbers, and you will get really amazing answers. Try and make your own interpretation. If you consider over here, it's a direct relationship between the total liabilities and debt to equity ratio formula. Probably you can consider this formula by using in various companies like, you know, Jet Airways, which is a highly leveraged company. You can see how exactly this ratio is working over there. I hope you have got a really great insight from this video. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.